Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding lonely and disinterested, written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the diplomatic tectonics. Now this is very important term that you should be using in your mains examination. Diplomatic tectonics. Now what is meant by diplomatic tectonics? Now diplomatic tectonics means alteration in the alliances, changes in the friendship of the countries. Now it primarily means that there is a change which takes place in the diplomatic realm. There are no permanent foes and there are no permanent friends in diplomacy. So why I am attaching the word tectonics with diplomacy? Now as far as tectonics is concerned, tectonics is never static. It is always changing. It is always altering. It is always creating new setups and new scenarios. And when it comes to diplomatic tectonics, the same thing is also happening in the diplomatic realm. Friends are created and acrimonies unfolds, and your friends, they become your foes in the diplomatic sphere. Now when it comes to India, now how India is managing this diplomatic tectonics? This is what this entire editorial is about. Now two important things are happening at the diplomatic landscape. The first thing that is happening is the alliance that is getting strengthened and formed and entrenched. And what is this alliance that I'm talking about? The alliance of China, the alliance of Russia and Pakistan. And along with that, they might also be joining Iran. Now presently, as far as this alliance is concerned, that is China, Russia and Pakistan, it is getting strengthened day by day. And second alteration that is taking place in the diplomatic tectonics is a step backward of United States of America from the landscape of Asia. Now United States of America is shrinking its diplomatic prowess. It is altering, it is metamorphosing the way it was conducting its diplomacy. Now this thing is having big repercussions for India. But as far as India is concerned, India is not making any substantive effort to remain relevant in diplomacy. Now this is another important keyword that you should be using in your mains examination. Relevant. Relevant in diplomacy. Now India's stance with respect to the changing diplomatic tectonics has been dormant. India has not been proactive and India is not managing its diplomatic affairs with respect to Asian countries and with respect to the Muslim world and with respect to the superpowers in a way so that it can derive benefit out of it. So this is one potent alliance that is emerging, and with respect to the counter to it is another alliance that is emerging. This alliance is the alliance of USA plus Japan plus Australia plus India, somewhat associated and aligned with the ideology of these countries. But when it comes to India, India is not considered to be a core member of this alliance. And when we compared these two alliances, these two groups, the alliance of China, Russia and Pakistan, this is more firm and this is more strong in comparison to the alliance of USA, Japan, Australia and India. Now, as far as this alliance is concerned, this alliance has a very important country, that of China. Now, in this alliance that is emerging at the global level, it is having two adversaries of India and one ex-friend of India. Now, what ex-friend I'm talking about? That is Russia. So it is actually a very big blow to India's diplomatic strategy. And this is the reason why Happy Mount Jacob has given the title of lonely. How India has been left lonely in this entire race of alliances. Economically, India has been left behind. Diplomatically, India has been left behind. And there are certain bodies like, take the case of SAARC, South Asian Association of Regional Corporation. Now, India has not maneuvered its diplomacy in a way so that it can derive benefits from SAARC. And this is one of the reasons why China's policy of encirclement and containment is getting strengthened day by day. China is trying to encircle India. China is trying to usurp all the lanes of the communication in the Indian Ocean. China is also trying to usurp the lanes of communication in the Pacific Ocean. China is trying to assert itself economically through its maritime route project. And through OBRO project, it is also trying to assert over the sovereignty and the integrity of India. So all the alliances that are unfolding, they are posing big questions. The questions to which India has got no answers. So if India really wants to remain relevant, if India really wants to give answer to the questions that are being raised in the new symmetries that are being created in the global diplomatic landscape, India really needs to create its own niche. And how can that niche be created? That niche can be created if India will align properly with the United States of America. And if India will use the economic leverage from countries like Japan and Australia to strengthen itself economically. If India will become partner of important groups like ASEAN and APEC, Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. Now, as far as APEC is concerned, India is not a member of it. So India really needs to become a member of such important groups. And India also needs to strengthen research in India and create its own IPs, patents, by which India will be able to create an economic resource, patent resource for itself. Because it is only the patent resource that really matters in the diplomatic relationships. And this is one of the reasons why the countries like China and America, they are controlling the entire diplomatic game. If India wants to remain relevant, it really needs to invest in this sphere. And this will also create a situation whereby India will no longer remain disinterested. And why India is disinterested? India is disinterested because it has nothing to offer to the world. Now, when it comes to Russia and China, they have a lot to offer to the world in terms of exports, in terms of communication lanes, and in terms of energy resources. And India also needs to rethink and re-strategize. Like I have already told you, it is diplomatic tectonics. Nothing is permanent in it. Now, when it comes to Russia and China, earlier they used to be adversaries. There was an acrimonious relationship. Achha relation nahi tha Russia aur China ka pehle. But agar aap relation ab dekhte ho, relation, it has improved. Rapprochement had set in between Russia and China. Now they are getting friendly with each other. Aspirant corps has set in between the relationship between Russia and China. Now such thing also should be structured by India. Such thing should also be engendered by India. With respect to China, India should not be touchy on the minor issues. Now in this editorial, he has discussed the issue of Azhar Masood. So India really needs to design a holistic and long-term diplomatic policy. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can also join my offline classes in Chandigarh. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.